Welcome to WebStylePress. I have an online store that had moderate traffic and clients. After adding significant amount of products and improving site structure and design, clients didn't increase that much. On checking site's health in Google Analytics and Google Search Console, I found out few issues. I will show you same issues in a test site on localhost. Then we will fix the issues. If you want to increase site views and convert more clients, you need to monitor every aspect of site and improve site based on Google suggestions. Even when it looks too much effort on small store, act on Google site improvement suggestions anyways. This is rich results test tool from Google. It will indicate problems with product listing data, if any. Fix those problems and clients will increase. Ultimately, sales will increase. I am using XAMPP. This is the local URL that I want to test. This is a test project. It's on localhost. I have used local tunnel to make the site live. I will link the tutorial to make local site available live in description. This is the URL converted from local to live. It's global and live from localhost URL and can be accessed from anywhere in the world until server is running. Now I will copy this URL and paste it in this tool. And results are showing a few errors. Two valid items detected, some have warnings. Six warnings. Invalid URL in field image, optional. Missing field aggregate rating, optional. Missing field review, optional. Missing field brand, optional. No global identifier provided. Now these are optional warnings, but if we fix these, our site performance in search results will increase. Let's provide a review for product and add a unique identifier to fix some of these problems. You see this aggregate rating and review and this global identifier. Okay, so this is the site, and I will just go ahead and post a review. Submit. Okay, we've got the review, and then this is that product in admin. And from inventory, we have got the SKU. Let's just put the random number in SKU and hit update. SKU stock keeping unit. Let's refresh this URL. And then retest this URL. One valid item with warning is detected. Okay, let's see. Okay, now we have got four warnings. So two warnings gone. Now we have got invalid URL field image, optional. Missing field brand, optional. No global identifier. GTIN, MPN, ISBN, optional. All right. So still, it needs global identifier value. Okay, now we have fixed some warnings manually. Similarly, you can add more data to make product appear better in search results. But we don't have any field named as brand and global identifier that we can provide from product page to make these warnings go away. So let me show you an easy way. I will go to the product and delete this comment or rating for this product. And then I will also go to inventory and delete this SKU. So that product is back to default. Our changes have been reverted. Now go to plugins, add new. Search for all-in-one schema. This is the one that we are looking for. Schema and structured data for WP and AMP. Install now. It's installed. Activate it. Okay, schema and structured data for WP and AMP. And go to settings. From settings, we have to provide some information like about page and contact page, website schema homepage, and site link search box, archive, schema type, article, and then WooCommerce archive, breadcrumbs, site navigation menu, main menu. Select the options that are obvious. And then there's knowledge graph, data type organization, organization type corporation. And this is just the test name, test legal name. And this is just the organization URL. That is also just the website homepage URL. This number is for testing purpose. And contact URL is also for testing purpose, just the homepage URL. We have just filled in dummy data. And then we have got this default data. We can upload default image. We can upload default image from here and specify default post image width and height from here. From here, we can enable reviews, but we don't need reviews for now. Also check out the advanced settings such as defragment schema markup, add schema markup in footer, pretty print schema markup, micro data cleanup, etc. And then basically that's it. Save settings. And with structured data installed and after applying basic settings, now go to this test page and retest that URL. Now we didn't provide the review. We did not provide the SKU or anything. And we just installed a plugin and applied some basic settings and provided some basic data. And here we are. Every problem is solved. Breadcrumb is there and the site link search box is there. And everything is fine now. And it will also not affect the product listing in any way. So every warning is gone by using this plugin. Try out this plugin to fix schema issues for your website. It will add Google Rich Snippets markup according to schema.org guidelines to structure your site for SEO. And it will hugely improve SEO for your site. All warnings and errors gone. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.